I'm John Seaman. I'm with Carrie Kautzer, and we're here at Road America Racetrack in Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin. Road America is a scenic 4-mile race course. We're covering the WeatherTech Brian Redman International Challenge for vintage race cars. This is one of the largest vintage racing events in the United States and features over 400 cars competing in 12 race groups. This weekend will showcase historic Can-Am in celebration of Can-Am's 54th anniversary and the 50th anniversary of the UOP Shadow Can-Am Racers. Additional race groups include Formula 5000, Vintage Production, Monopostal Formula, Big Bore, Modern Production, Stock Cars, and a special Porsche race. Be prepared to watch some exciting racing action. I'm with Jason Miller, and he is from Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin. Jason's been racing for quite a few years, and this year he's had an opportunity to step up to a Can-Am UOP Shadow. Oh, tell us about that experience, Jason.
Well, it's absolutely the most wonderful experience that I can imagine. The car is just wonderfully prepared by RM Motorsports, and Jim Bartel, who has all these shadows, is, you know, graciously allowed me to run the car, and I'm just having a blast. I did a little practicing in February in Palm Beach with all the Can-Am cars, and then last year I was able to run the Shadow Formula 5000 car. Jim entered me in that, and we had a successful run and won the class.
Now we're here at Road America for the 50th anniversary of the Shadow. So it's a great event. There's like 13 of the Shadows here, and you've had a chance to run the car now on Road America. So tell us about that.
Road America, I'm a little biased, is the best racetrack in the country. To drive such an iconic car like a Shadow at Road America, I don't know too many people in the world that has had that opportunity, and I'm blessed to do it. It certainly requires a lot of skill and gentle on the throttle, but it handles great, and I'm having a blast.
A little bit on the specifications of the car. What year is it, etc.?
It's a Mark III 1973 Shadow. It's basically got a Chevrolet-powered motor, big block, and it goes pretty quick.
Yep. We'll be right back. I'm with Robert Blaine, and he has one of the newer cars here at the Vintage Races this week. Robert, give us some information on the car.
The car is a Honda HPD 2012 chassis. Honda commissioned a company called Worth Research to construct the chassis. Worth is over in the UK, and they do a lot of very specialty aerodynamics for not only the race car industry, but for the aviation industry as well. And this car's gone through several iterations, not this one particular, but just the evolution of the chassis. They started out with an AXR01 chassis, That was the car that Duncan Dayton's Highcroft team ran, Jill DeFerrin ran. Very successful 8-cylinder engine in it. Then they went to the 02, and that was a very brief iteration. They had put the 2.8 six-cylinder turbo in the car, and they reconfigured the aero on this, and it came out as an 03. Again, with the 2.8-liter twin-turbo V6. The car itself in 2013 won the Long Beach race, and they finished second at Sebring behind the 908 Peugeot. This is a great car. I mean, the brakes on it are fantastic. The handling is so confidence-inspiring. I'm going in so deep into the corners, so fast through the carousel. Yeah. I'm pulling sixth gear through the kink. Not quite manly enough yet to put the gas pedal all the way to the floor, but I'm getting there. It's a very torquey motor with a pretty low RPM range. And it takes some getting used to, because I'm used to revving engines to 10,000 RPMs. And the shift light's on here at 6,700. And you're just, as fast as you can move your fingers, you're going through the gears. This car was sitting over kind of on the side. The young man, Rick Capone, who's taking care of it, was there. So Debbie says, "Bobby, look at that." And I go, "That's really nice." She goes, "Let's go look." And I said, "I already have enough cars." She goes, "Come on, let's go look." So we go over, stand there looking at it, talked with Rick for about 10 minutes or so, and just admiring it. It just came from a fresh restoration that Rick had done. And she says, "Well, Bobby, ask him the question." And I said, "What? How much?" She goes, "Nah, do you fit?" That's how I got the car. But she told me I had to have a car. Uh-huh. You don't find many wives like that, I have to admit. I'm a lucky boy.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm with Walter Volrath, and he has a Lola T290. Give us some information on the car. I understand it has some racing history.
Well, Kodak Lola was the first Lola to win at Le Mans back in 1972, and it was not sponsored by Lola. It was independently sponsored, and it actually beat the team cars. I purchased the car from Keith Fraser, who lives in Canada, and he kept it in Seattle, and I went out to Seattle approximately 3.5 years ago to check out the car, and fell in love with it right away, and purchased it, and then moved it back here. Actually took delivery done at the vintage race at Indianapolis, you know, racing it here at Road America, and down at Black Hawk Farms. So it's a great car to drive. It's got a Cosworth BDG engine in it, which puts out about 300 horse. And this morning I qualified it third, actually, with a 220.9. It's a beautiful car to drive. It handles exceptionally well. It's prepared great by my my crew here, Greg Borland at Arms Up Motorsports. I've been coming here since I was 12 years old as a spectator, and started driving in 2004, which was an SCCA and a Formula Continental, and did very well in that. And then about 10 years ago, I started getting into the vintage racing. It's the premier track in the country, not just because I live here, but it 4 miles, a lot of turns, very high speed straightaways, and everything is just run perfectly. I mean, the track right now this weekend, I've never seen it in such great condition.
I really would like to compliment George Brugenthies, the former president and CEO of Road America, and now Mike Kircher and his crew. What a wonderful job they do with the facility. It's like I mentioned earlier, it's a beautiful track. The grounds are immaculate, and the safety features are second to none.